Good morning, students. Could you hear me? So we shall move on to the lecture today. The topic of the lecture is on viscose rayon. So this viscose rayon is the oldest regenerated cellulosic fiber. Here, the raw material used for making this fiber is a natural polymer. Like, for example, cellulose. Cellulose is the natural polymer from which the rayon is made. It is manufactured from the spruce wood and cotton linters. Means the source of cellulose which you are using as a raw material is, it is the wood, because wood is rich in cellulose. So you use some woods like spruce wood or cotton linters you can use, from where you can extract the cellulose. So this is the oldest fiber. This was the research for this fiber started during 1880s in UK by Cross, Bevan and Beadle. Some three scientists started to research about the viscose rayon, and around 1905 the Samuel Kotal company, they were in the serious production of viscose rayon, and they produced this viscose rayon fiber through some different techniques. They have used different steps they have used to make the viscose rayon. So what is this viscose rayon? It is a regenerated cellulosic fiber that we know, because we are using manufacturing this fiber from a natural polymer, which is the cellulose. That raw material for that cellulose, we use a wood like spruce wood. So what happens chemically here, you know well that viscose rayon is also chemically, it is the cellulose only, but what happens, what is the difference in the reaction, what is the chemistry that we are going to see? So here what we do is we treat the wood pulp with the cellulose, with the alkali, so that what happens, the cellulose, which is the main unit present in the wood, that polymer, that after reacting with the alkali, what will happen is it tries to change the molecular structure little, so that the cellulose one in the polymer chains that will be converted into a more thermodynamically stable type of a cellulose called cellulose 2. So that what will happen, it will move the amorphous and crystalline area, so that the crystallinity increases a little, so that you can do the further processes like xanthation or xanthation process, which you will be doing after some steps, so that you can dissolve it in the water or sodium hydroxide, and then you can again regenerate the cellulose fiber. Okay, so here the cellulose groups are drawn together, and then through the two important forces, one is the van der Waals force and the hydrogen bonding, to obtain the cellulose 2 network. This cellulose 2 is a thermodynamically stable form of a cellulose when compared with the cellulose 1. So that is what is shown here. Here you can see here cellulose 1 and 2, more or less it looks the same, how the inter and intramolecular hydrogen bonding is observed. So what happens when you manufacture this process in a brief way, you need to know what happens during this manufacturing process. A number of physical and chemical processes start simultaneously when you do the spinning, that is the viscose rayon spinning. So these four steps are very important, which we are going to discuss in detail in the forthcoming slides. One is the coagulation of the liquid filament to the xanthate gel filament. You convert the cellulose, coagulate the filament so that it will be converted into xanthate gel filament, and then you do the neutralization and acidification of the gel filament, and then you will de-swell the gel filament with the help of a zinc that we are going to see, and then you will de-xanthate this gel filament. If you observe in these four important steps, you can see initially you do the xanthation and acidification, and finally you do the de-swelling and de-xanthation. Finally, this viscose rayon which is produced will not contain the xanthate groups also, and it will not contain the any kind of acid or other groups also. Only the viscose rayon will be there without any kind of a groups. This is for, these steps are done for certain purpose where you will substitute some groups present in the cellulose and then finally you will regenerate the cellulose. That is the viscose rayon. From every step we will understand in detail how the viscose rayon is manufactured. So this is the flow diagram for the production of viscose rayon filament. You can see the steps, there are many steps present in the manufacture of viscose rayon fiber. You see the first step is the steeping, then shredding, then aging, then xanthation, then dissolution, then blending, ripening, filtration and deaeration, then spinning, then neutralization, purification and finishing, then drying and then winding. It contains many steps in the manufacture. So we will see each one by one. What is the steeping? Steeping means you take the cellulose pulp boards like this, arrange them in a layer and then you keep it in a container which contains some 17.5 to 18% sodium hydroxide. So you immerse it at a temperature of say 18 degrees centigrade, similar to the mercerization reaction which you do it. But normally mercerization is done for a less time, like few seconds. But here you do it for 30 to 60 minutes, you are doing a steeping process. So that what will happen during this reaction, the cellulose C6H10O5, when it reacts with sodium hydroxide, it will be converted to alkali cellulose. You convert it into alkali cellulose. Here the cellulose one, which is the thermodynamically less stable, and the crystalline regions which are in the monoclinic form, they are converted to more thermodynamically stable form, which is the cellulose 2. This is the first step in the reaction. And once the recommended time is completed, you need to remove the excess alkali so that in that container itself there will be a ram fitted, so that the ram is for squeezing out the excess alkali, so that you can ensure that only the press weight ratio, that is how much pressure you are giving to squeeze the wood pulp to remove the alkali, that is important. You can control it by adjusting the press weight ratio to around 2.7 to 3, so that you remove the excess alkali. Then next is the shredding. From the name itself you can understand, shredding means into where something is cut into pieces. So it is a mechanical operation where whatever alkali cellulose you have prepared, that alkali cellulose bolts will be cut into small pieces. You use some grinding machine and then you cut them into small pieces. How do you do this? You take a container which contains some rotating serrated blades like a grinder, like a mixie, and then you use a time of say 1 to 3 hours at a little higher temperature, say 25 to 35 degrees centigrade, and then you do grinding. Then after this, what you do is you introduce a surfactant in the reaction. Okay, in this grinding, when you do the grinding, you add the surfactant like polyethylene glycol. I hope you all know what is meant by a surfactant. Surfactant is the surface active agent, like a soap, which is used to reduce the surface tension. Okay, so once you add the surface tension, what will happen? For the forthcoming reactions like xanthation, it will help. Okay, so that when during the xanthation we are going to add a chemical that can easily disperse and then substitute around this cellulose chains. So that is the reason you add the surfactant. Then third step is the aging step. So this is the aging. You know very well that you keep something for a more time, so that like a storing for some time. Okay, so here what you do is whatever pieces of alkali cellulose that you have made in the previous step, that you are going to store it in a container and with a closed airtight system, so that only some oxygen is inside that container that is going to react with the alkali cellulose, so that you will not allow any kind of outside carbon dioxide to react with the alkali cellulose. So that what will happen in this, here some depolymerization is going to happen. Okay, so here it is an oxidative depolymerization step. So here oxygen you have introduced in the container, so that oxygen is going to do the depolymerization. You need to control it so that to obtain the desired degree of polymerization. Okay, in case for example if you are doing some for some other viscose rayon like polynosic viscose rayon where you do not want to control it, the degree of polymerization, this step may not be required. But for viscose rayon, you need to control the degree of polymerization so that you do this aging process. Okay. So how long you carry out? Similarly, like 25 to 30 degree temperature you use, and you use it for a little more time, like 1 to 3 days. You can do the process very fast. If you add some catalyst like heavy metals like manganese or cobalt, if you add, you can reduce the time, or you can use the higher temperature, you can reduce the time of aging. So that finally what you do get in this process is you do the oxidative depolymerization step, and viscosity of the solution, whatever viscosity is there, that gets affected from the solution, from this process called the aging. Because all these steps you are carrying out, especially the shredding and aging, you carry out so that you can effectively do the xanthation, because xanthation is a very important process that we are going to see. So this is the xanthation process. Here what you do is, so far you have, what you did, you took the wood and then wooden boards, and then did the steeping, shredding and aging you have done. During the shredding you have introduced the surfactant for the dispersion of the carbon disulfide, everything you have done. So now here you are going to do the xanthation, where you are actually going to introduce the chemical called carbon disulfide. Okay, you add around say 32 to 35% on weight of the cellulose, in the alkali cellulose, in a container where it is rotated. This carbon disulfide, after you introduce into that alkali cellulose, that container will be rotating around say 1 to 4 revolutions per minute in that particular speed for 1 to 3 hours at 20 to 30 degrees centigrade. This reaction will take place where the alkali cellulose will react with the carbon disulfide to produce the sodium cellulose xanthate. You can see here, wherever the cellulose molecules is there, it is substituted with the xanthate groups present here. You can see here, CSSNA, CS2NA groups will get substituted. That is the sodium cellulose xanthate. The sodium xanthate groups gets substituted with the liberation of one byproduct called sodium trithiocarbamate. Okay, this is a little, this byproduct has certain color, so that it will be orange in color, because it is something, a byproduct which is liberated from this reaction. So here the main intention behind this, doing this xanthation, is you substitute the xanthate, sodium xanthate groups among the cellulose chains. Okay, so next step is the dissolution step. So here you have substituted the xanthate groups among the cellulose chains, so that now the cellulose xanthate, you have to dissolve it. Okay, normally cellulose, it is not soluble in water. You see, cellulose is not soluble in water. So here you have converted into cellulose xanthate, so that what will happen, it can dissolve, because it has the groups, you can see it has been substituted with the sodium xanthate group, so that it can dissolve it in water. You can dissolve it in a water, or you can use a alkali, so that you can use 4 to 6% solution of alkali you can use, and you can use a device where, like a cylindrical vessel which is equipped with some agitator, so that if you do some agitation, that solution, the sodium xanthate which is prepared, will dissolve to form a fluid. Okay, then what you need to do is you need to do the filtration. This filtration process, it is not only you do it here, you will do it at various stages in the process, but here what you do is you just filter them, so that you remove the excess impurities whichever is present, and any undissolved particles is there, you just separate them out, and then you do the filtration, and then you do the blending. It is not that there is only one container and one group of boards where you add the alkali cellulose. There will be different containers will be there. There will be different cellulose pulp boards and wood pulp boards, and you will do the process so that you combine everything to make a homogeneous system. Okay, so that what will happen, there won't be any kind of a batch to batch variation. This is the blending process. Then finally, it is the we come to the ripening process. Okay. So like xanthation, this is also very, very important process. So here, this ripening, why we are doing this ripening process, we want the fluid that which we have produced, the viscose rayon fluid which we have prepared, that we need to do the spinning to convert it into filament. Before doing that spinning process, we need to ensure that whether that fluid, whether it has achieved the suitable property to undergo spinning. So how will you do that? There is a thing called coagulation. Okay, the viscose rayon which is produced will contain a viscous type of a liquid which is produced. That liquid should be coagulable. Okay, that is called the coagulable. So that once it has attained the coagulability, you can use it for spinning. So once after it attains the coagulation, then if you do the spinning, you can regenerate the cellulosic filament, regenerated cellulosic filament, which is a viscose filament, you can make. So here what you do after you do the filtration and blending, you store the fluid in the container and keep it for 1-3 days, like a temperature of say 15-25. It is just a storage. Once you store it for some time, it will coagulate. The solution will coagulate. Okay. See here, you can see during the coagulation process, the main reaction that is taking place is here. This is the sodium cellulose xanthate. Here the sodium is there, and here cellulose is there. This is the xanthate group. This will react with water to convert it into cellulose, and carbon disulfide will get liberated from this. Will be released from that. But it is not that all the carbon disulfide gets removed. Only a certain portion of the carbon disulfide gets removed. But still, you ensure that the solution is coagulated. Once it is coagulated, then it is ready for spinning. That is the understanding from this ripening step. So this coagulability, which I have told you, it is the index of ripeness. It means that it has achieved the ripened so that it can be ready for doing the spinning. Okay. So what happens during this process that we need to know, some xanthate groups which I have told you that will get decomposed and then it will be converted to cellulose chains, and the viscosity of the solution will drop. So that what will happen, some redistribution of xanthate group increases among the total cellulosic network, and some desanthation take place, and agglomeration of cellulose molecules also take place to reduce the solubility. So that is the reason why here, because of the desanthation, this carbon disulfide in certain portions, it gets removed from this process. This is a very important stage where you confirm that the viscose rayon fluid is ready for spinning. That is the measured by the coagulability. Okay, next step is the spinning. Now we have confirmed that our solution is coagulable. There are certain tests which we do it, but that is not we do not want to discuss it here, but still I'm just telling you there are some two different tests which we do it to confirm whether the viscose rayon is ready to coagulate. It is achieved the coagulability so that you can do the spinning. Otherwise, with the prescribed time limit and temperature limit, if you store it for some time, then it is an understanding that it has coagulated. So now you do the spinning. So this viscose rayon, it is not spun by other spinning techniques like melt spinning or dry spinning. Here we do the wet spinning, which is a solution spinning. So here what you do is you take the cellulosic the viscose rayon fluid that you have prepared so far in the different steps. In that solution, you are going to add some ingredients. Okay, you are going to add some ingredients in the spin bath so that you can regenerate the cellulose filament. Okay, that is the regenerate viscose filament from that. So what you will add in that viscose rayon spin bath, that you need to know. So here you see there are three important ingredients which you are going to add. One is the salting out agent, which is the sodium sulfate. This is for this is a salting out agent which you will be adding around 16 to 24%, and a regenerating agent, which is the acid, which is the sulfuric acid, you will add 8 to 10%, and the compound forming agent, which is the zinc sulfate, which is the you add very less of say 1 to 2%. So here what you do is you are going to do the wet spinning. Hope you all know what is wet spinning. First you will dissolve a polymer in a solvent, and then it will after that solution, after the then you do the spinning, wet spinning, and the spin, the spinning after spinning the filament is made. When it comes out, it will be again immersed in a non-solvent to remove the solvent, and then it will be wound. Okay, so that is the wet spinning. Here, what is the use of these ingredients that we are with, that we are supposed to know? Especially the regenerating agent and the compound forming agent, these are very much important. One is that we regenerate the viscose filament with the help of the sulfuric acid. Okay, here this addition of sulfuric acid is very important because the pH at which it works is very important, because at that particular pH only our we are going to regenerate the viscose rayon. So this is a acid decomposition reaction. Okay, if you observe this reaction, this is the sodium cellulosanthate. This will react with the sulfuric acid to regenerate the cellulose. See, this cellulose is the viscose rayon cellulose. Okay, so how do you do it? You add these ingredients in the bath. So here you add a salting out reagent also to remove some excess salt. You can remove the salts, and you add a sulfuric acid. I have told it is a regenerating agent where you will regenerate the cellulose with the help of a sulfuric acid. Then what is the use of this compound forming agent called the zinc sulfate? That is very important, because here zinc plays a very important role in the this reaction, which is called the structural regulation. Okay, the structure gets regulated. You see, you hear in the viscose fiber, when you do this before you do the spinning, you need to orient the cellulose molecules in the direction of the fiber axis, then only you will get the strength. Otherwise, what will happen, the cellulose molecules, whichever you are making the filament, if it is not properly oriented, then it will not have the good strength properties, then it will lead to some poor dry strength, and other tensile strength properties will get affected. So here the addition of a zinc is very, very important. So what do you, what does that zinc do? That I have already told you, it is the structural regulation. So let us see in the chemically what happens when you add the zinc. Here you see you are going to introduce the zinc in the reaction when this process spinning in the spin ball, when you are introducing the zinc, what will happen is this zinc will react with the cellulose to form zinc cellulose xanthate. You can see here, this is the zinc cellulose xanthate. Okay, so this zinc cellulose xanthate should be formed very fast before you regenerate the cellulosic fiber. Okay, just understand this. This zinc cellulose xanthate, it is a very it is a type of a bivalent metal. This forms certain cross links with the cellulose xanthate. Okay, so once it forms a temporary type of a cross links over the cellulose xanthate, what will happen is when the acid reacts with that, it will first make the orientation, it will first ensure the orientation, and then your viscose rayon filament will get extruded as a filament. Okay, so this will happen only at a particular concentration of a sulfuric acid when you use. For example, if you use a high concentration or a low concentration, that is going to play a important role here. So here the pH, if you use it very high, then what will happen, the viscose rayon will be first regenerated before undergoing the orientation. Okay, So that is, we are not interested in. But when we use a less concentration, like an optimum concentration, that time what will happen? There will be a competition between the zinc ions and the hydrogen ions. That hydrogen ion comes from the sulfuric acid. So we want the zinc to occupy the cellulose polymer chains so that it will form a, first it will form a zinc xanthate gel. So that gel, you can extend it. You can just stretch it, okay, to arrange them in the proper fiber axis direction. So that after that, when you add the, after that, you can extrude the filament, because already some minimum concentration of sulfuric acid is there to, for the pH is there, so that you can extrude the viscose rayon filament with a good strength. Otherwise, if you use a high concentration of acid, that time what will happen? Before the formation of the zinc xanthate gel, the hydrogen ions will react very fast to extrude the filament. That is not we are interested in. In that case, what will happen? It will lead to less strength. Okay. So first we should ensure that the pH of the solution bath is very important, and that will happen when you use a optimum concentration of an acid pH to form a tough zinc xanthate gel. That gel, you can extend it so that after that is stretched to the fiber axis direction, then you will get the orientation. Then if you extrude the filament, then you will get the good crystal sizes and crystallinity you will obtain, so that you will get the strength, viscose rayon with a good strength. So that is the understanding why we are adding the zinc. So zinc is the role of zinc is the structural regulation, and zinc is a bivalent metal. It forms cross links with the xanthate groups and forms a zinc cellulose xanthate. That zinc cellulose xanthate, it is stable to acid induced degradation. It will only slowly react. Otherwise, if you add a very high concentration of acid, in that case, zinc cannot easily occupy the polymer chain links, and acid induced regeneration will be very fast. Before orienting the cellulose polymer chains, this fiber will get extruded. Okay, so that is very important to know from the this manufacturing of viscose rayon. From this reaction, you manufacture the viscose rayon. These are so I will just brief out what we have discussed so far. The first step is the steeping, where you steep the, you take the cellulose wood pulp boards, wood pulp is the raw material, you steep them, then you cut them into pieces by shredding. Third step, you do the aging, which is the oxidative depolymerization. Fourth step, you do the xanthation, which is very important, where you introduce the carbon disulfide so that that cellulose which is formed will dissolve in alkali or water. Then you do the filtration and blending. Then you do the ripening. After ripening only, you come to know that the solution is coagulable and ready for the making the filament. And after that, you do the wet spinning. And in the wet spinning, you add some three ingredients. And what are the roles of each and every ingredient? That is very important. So all these viscose rayon is a very complex, lengthy process where you involve various steps to make the viscose rayon fiber. Okay. So that's all about the viscose rayon. And finally, after you extrude the filament, you will do some additional process, like you need to remove any kind of a sulfur present in the viscose rayon, or any kind of a metal that is present, so that finally the viscose rayon should contain only the cellulose and not any other chemical or any metal or anything. Everything has to be removed, and you do the bleaching also. You apply some spin finish and then you do the winding. Okay. So that is how you manufacture the viscose rayon. So I am stopping here for today. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Otherwise, we can just stop here for today.